Via is a New York-based mobility company that provides van services, data, and software to transit agencies, companies, provides paratransit services, and a broad range of transportation services, though the focus is primarily working with cities, transit agencies, companies in some cases.
One of the ways we think about what VIA is doing is getting people out of their private car and into public transportation to help us reduce congestion, combat greenhouse gas emissions and climate change, and advance equity. We have cities all over the country where access to public transportation is limited. Basically, in most American cities, you need a car to get nearly anywhere you're going. And many people don't have a car. A car is the second largest expense for most American families. Public transportation is crucial, but severely limited for most people. Take, for example, Metro Atlanta, where 70% of the population can't get to a hospital or a clinic within 30 minutes by public transit. They can't get to a grocery store or convenience store within 30 minutes. The inspiration for VIA started was a modest beginning. We started with a class of public transit that we have back in Israel, where Oren, my co-founder, and I are from. And the idea really originated where Oren was trying to ride one of these services and was waiting for these vans to come by. These are called Chirut taxis, that are vans that essentially run along the bus routes. And he was waiting for these vans to show up, and they kept showing up full, and he could never get a seat. And it occurred to him, it would be great if I could book a ride on an app through my phone, so I know that I have a seat that's guaranteed, and I know when the vehicle is coming. And we started building on that, saying, well, if we're reserving the seat on our app, well, then now we know where we are and where we need to go, and we can start to transform the entire system into a dynamic system, one where the routes are not necessarily fixed, where the routes can be changed based on demand, where we can use data to plan where we position the vehicles and what routes the vehicles are taking.
It differs from Uber and Lyft fundamentally because its core customer base would be transit agencies and cities rather than relying solely on private ride-based business as Uber and Lyft do.
We can track our pizza the moment it leaves the oven all the way until it gets to our home. But we have no idea when we put our child on the school bus whether she got there, when she'll be coming back. That has to change, and the software that we're developing is transforming that in a major way across hundreds of cities all over the world. 10 years ago, when we founded VIA, my co-founder Oren and I set out to transform how public transportation works, to develop technology for a sector that had very little access to technology, and just broaden access across the world for people to use new forms of public transit and get them where they need to go more easily and more conveniently. What we found was that that mission was significantly harder than we expected, because back then, cities, transit authorities viewed investment in technology as a cost. They were proud when they spent less on technology than their peers, seeing it as a way to measure their efficiency. And we tried to argue the opposite, that technology can improve your efficiency, that it can dramatically improve how you run your services, the visibility you have into your operations, and the quality of service that you provide to your residents. And it's taken quite a few years to get there, but today this is mainstream. It's accepted by nearly every public transit agency in the world, and we've seen that through adoption of our services in over 500 cities.
The business has worked out fairly well so far, and the company is worth an estimated $2.9 billion at its most recent valuation, according to PitchBook. It could be worth considerably more in the not too distant future if, as expected, the company moves ahead with plans to list shares publicly in the United States. It's hard to predict the future for the company, and as concerns around COVID-19 continue, that could dampen demand for its services longer term, in that many passengers may not want to share rides with lots of other people when they don't know their health status or their COVID status.
Transit tech is a new category that we believe we've created, and now many others are following in our footsteps. A model is to partner with cities. We think a lot of times people look at local government, they look at cities, and they see those entities as blockers for progress, blockers for innovation. And we think exactly the opposite. We work together with cities to enable progress, to enable innovation, and to bring technology to folks who need it the most. And in some sense, the only way to do that is through partnership with the public sector, whether it's school districts that we provide software to. The key to working together with cities and transit authorities and other governmental bodies is to recognize that it has to be a partnership, that we need to listen to what they need. We needed to create a platform, a software platform, that was incredibly flexible because their needs are very diverse. Transportation is very local. Every municipality has its own needs. What you're required to do is build a platform that can really address the needs of everyone, whoever they are and wherever they are. And that's something that can only happen when you work together with the city. Our data allows us to know where we need to put vehicles, where those vehicles should drive, when to expect that passengers will want to ride those services, and how to best adapt to traffic conditions that are always changing.
VIA is also likely to be a key beneficiary of the U.S. infrastructure bill that is awaiting passage in Congress right now. That bill would make available $39 billion in additional funding for U.S. transportation agencies and cities to upgrade their transit offerings.
We believe that the federal infrastructure bill that's now being debated by Congress will significantly improve public transportation across the country, and this is a very important goal. This adds meaningful funding to highly needed programs, and we're very supportive of this. This country needs investment in physical infrastructure, in bridges, in roads, in rail, but it also needs investment in digital infrastructure. We need to build better data to support our transit systems so that they're more efficient. We need to invest in digital systems and the sorts of software that we build and others to make transportation far more advanced and far smarter through technology.